Bridge Kids. Today we are going to play Pictionary. In our story, the Israelites celebrate that the wall is rebuilt. When we celebrate with foods. Guess what? I am going to draw with Katrina.
Okay, let's see. The banana.
Mm-mm.
Carrot?
Mm-mm.
Let me see what you're gonna do. Let's see. I think ice cream cone.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, now Katrina's gonna go. And Madeline and you all will try and guess what Katrina is.
Watermelon. Couscous? Rice?
Yes, rice.
Got a bowl of rice. Good job. Now what are we gonna do?
Sing some praises to our very good God.
I'm feeling sad.
You are good.
Even then. time to pray. Today, we are going to praise God. And praising God means that we are going to tell him great things about himself. You like to be praised, don't you? If you draw a picture or sing a song, you like it when your mommy and daddy say, "Good job, you are great." So today, let's tell God how he is great. You can tell him whatever you think in your heart, okay? I will go first, and then you pray. God, you are great. You are so loving. You are kind. You're so creative, God. Now it's your turn. God, we love you. Thank you for being such a good God. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Good job, guys. Did you know that the Bible is the most important book there is? Because it's God's words to us, to tell us about God and to tell us about Jesus. And today is Valentine's Day. That's a holiday about love. And the Bible tells us that God is love. In our story today, the people are so happy that the temple and the walls have been rebuilt. And so they have a big celebration, like a holiday. And they listen to someone teach the Bible. Let's find out how they felt as they heard the words of God.
Hello, everyone. I'm Megan.
And I'm Jesse. Megan, watch this. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength.
Jesse, that's part of a verse from our Bible story today. Did you read that?
Yep. I've been working on my reading.
Jesse, that's amazing. I'm so proud of you. And there's no better book to practice reading than the Bible.
Aw, thanks, Megan. You're making me blush.
You will be just like Ezra before you know it.
Ezra? Who is that?
Ezra is the priest in today's Bible story. He stood on a tall platform and read God's word to the people.
Oh, cool.
Listen to the story. The walls around Jerusalem were finally finished. The people had worked very hard, and God had helped them. One morning, the people got together. Men, women, and children came to hear Ezra, the priest, read God's word. The sun was just coming up when Ezra carried out God's word so he could read it. God's words were written on a scroll. Ezra stood on a tall platform and opened the scroll. Everyone could see it. Ezra began to read God's word aloud. The people in the crowd listened carefully. Everyone stood up. Ezra praised God, and the people lifted up their hands. "Amen! Amen!" the people said. Then they bowed down with their faces close to the ground. All the people worshiped God together. Some of the leaders there explained God's words to the people. They helped the people understand what Ezra read. When the people understood God's word, they were sad. The words from God were about how to live, and the people had not been living the way God wanted them to live. They were sorry for disobeying God. Ezra, his helpers, and Nehemiah, the governor, said, "This day is special. Do not be sad. Do not cry. This was a happy day." Ezra said, "Go home and get ready to have a feast. Eat good food and drink good drinks. Share what you make with people who don't have any food or drinks." Then Ezra said again, "Today is a special day. Be happy. God makes us strong." So the people did what Ezra told them to do. Nehemiah led the people to turn back to God. They promised to worship only God and obey Him. The Bible teaches us about God and Jesus. It helps us know the right things to do. We do wrong things a lot, but God can change our hearts and help us say no to sin. Jesus died to rescue us from sin.
When the people heard God's words, they realized they hadn't been doing what God wanted them to do. And so they felt sorry for disobeying God, and they promised they would obey. But they needed God's help. He had to change their hearts, because sometimes our hearts don't want to obey. And that's why Jesus came, and He died for our bad choices. And now, if we trust in Jesus, He gives us a new heart, and He helps us say no to sin and yes to God. Thank you, Jesus. And now it's time to answer some questions and see what you learned from today's story. We'll see you here next time. Bye.